In today's episode, I'm going to show you how you can pull in assets from NPM and use them within your app via the asset pipeline without having to touch Webpacker. I'm a big fan of Water CSS. It's a really nice little CSS library where it's just a CSS style sheet which makes most web pages look quite pretty without too much work. Right now, our app is pretty unstarred, and that's fine. I've only set up asset pipeline and I haven't done too much with Webpacker. So we're going to quickly add this to our app, and we've got the name of the package here. It's water.css. So I'm going to quickly go to my terminal here, and I'm just going to look at what folder or files I have and what folders. So I do have node modules already and a package.json. If you don't have a package.json file, just type yarn init and that'll create it. If you do have one, just have a quick look at it. And it will probably look something a little bit like this, where it just kind of says what JavaScript assets you have downloaded. Once you've done that, just type yarn add and water.css. The name of the package is water.css. And that's going to go off and download that file to our local machine and make it available for our Rails app to use. So if I was to quickly do cat package.json now, you can see it's just been added into the bottom there. Okay, and if we were to quickly open our app here in the editor, and we go to node modules, it takes a second to load because node modules is a very big file. We can see we've got water CSS added in there. And if I open it and have a quick look, we have these little CSS files, which is pretty good. I'm just going to open the minified one in a new tab and then copy its path to my clipboard. Okay, so right here I'm using the style sheet link tag. That's gonna open this file, which currently has nothing in it. So I'm just gonna add in a little reference to that file we just added. So that's cool. So I'm just gonna quickly refresh my app. We're gonna see like what errors occur. There's definitely gonna be one. So we can see it currently can't find that module, and this is where it's looking. So you can see it's not actually looking in node modules yet. So we have to tell Rails to go look in there. So the way we do that is we go to our assets initializer, which if I just open it up, come on. Do that, do the thing, come on. There we go. I'm really good at Vim. So it lives in config, initializers and assets. There's this little line in here where it mentions node modules. I'm just going to uncomment that so you can see it a bit better. What that's doing, it's saying, hey, go look in node modules for assets. And we can use this for our JavaScript and CSS assets. It doesn't really matter. But yeah, let's now quickly restart Rails. There we go. Nice and restarted. We can see we now have this new line here saying, hey, I'm looking in node modules, but I'm not finding it. That's because I started it with the word node modules, which we can now drop that from our CSS file. So I'm just going to get rid of that. So it's going to look in node modules for the path name water CSS out water min. So yeah, there we go. So it's just loaded that in. It's pulled in that file from NPM, and then we can use it in our app. And if we were to deploy it, we don't have to add that CSS file to our version control, which is really, really good. I really, really like this technique. It's really good for putting in all the good stuff in NPM, which is like lots of like things like jQuery, maybe Bootstrap, like other libraries where they normally just appear. They used to be handled by gems, but I think it's more sensible to pull them in via yarn. And that's that. I hope you enjoyed this episode. Not many people know about this technique. You can add this to old Rails applications as well, like Rails 5, and it will work quite nicely. So I highly recommend it. So make sure you smash that like button. If you have any comments or questions, just drop a comment below. I normally read all of them, and I always enjoy reading it. I will catch everyone next week. Thank you for watching.